Hello ladies and gentlemen, my name is Mr. TARDIS and welcome to the final viewing figures breakdown video for Doctor Who Series 11. The 7-day numbers are in for Doctor Who Resolution. We had an overnight figure of 5.15 million and now we have a 7-day figure of 7.12 million. Some outlets have been reporting 7.13 million but that's because they've been rounding up from the actual full figure of 7,125,999. But either way, that is a substantial increase from that pretty disappointing overnight figure. That is a 38.2% increase. That is the biggest increase of the 7-day viewership that we have seen for Series 11. The Woman Who Fell to Earth saw an increase of 33.6%, and this has got around 5% higher. And that bump through the BARB 4-screen dashboard and on-demand and BBC iPlayer means that Resolution now ranks third for New Year's Day, as opposed to the fourth ranking it got with its overnight viewing figures. It overtook Emmerdale, but it lagged behind Luther and Coronation Street. It is the third most watched programme of New Year's Day 2019. But if you look at the whole viewing figures for the week, the number one most viewed show was the New Year's Eve fireworks on BBC One, which got 12.39 million. And while Luther did do really well, all four of its episodes are in the top 10 of the BARB figures, it was not the most watched drama of the week. That was the ITV drama Manhunt, which just crushed it with 9.17 million. But apart from Manhunt, this really was Luther's week, starting off at 9.08 million and then finishing on Friday with 7.58 million. A dip, but considering that it's four episodes of an adult drama, that's a pretty good hold. We'll get to Doctor Who in a moment, but I do want to touch upon Luther's success, because this type of bingeable show, which you just put it all on the platform either at the same time or within a couple of days of each other, is something the BBC has been experimenting with over the past couple of years. A couple of years ago, I worked on Peter Kay's Car Share Series 2, and if you remember that show, all of the episodes were put on the BBC iPlayer at one time, and then they were shown week on week on BBC One. And I got chatting to some of the higher-ups at the BBC and on that production, and they said when it comes to the viewing figures, you see a substantial uptick when an entire series is put on a streaming platform. Because viewing habits show that while most people do watch on TV for the overnight figures, the number of people who wait for a series to end and then just binge it on their respective platform is quite notable. And while I can't say that's exactly what happened with Luther, it makes sense. They wait for the Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday episodes to finish, and then for the weekend, when they've got 4 hours spare, they just binge the whole thing in one go. We're never going to see if something like this happens with Doctor Who, because that spans over the course of 10 weeks, as opposed to the 28 days that the BARB measure, but I just wanted to let you folks know, I think the more people are informed about TV practices and viewing figure habits, the more constructive the conversations can be. But yeah, Luther came back in force, Manhunt started, and that really didn't leave much competition for other dramas, with the only drama that's not a soap opera in the top 15 being Doctor Who, with 7.12 million. And when it comes to other Doctor Who holiday specials, the rankings, they don't change. It is still the lowest viewed holiday special, but like I mentioned last week, when you look at the rankings for the respective days, it does fare pretty well. It ranks above Twice Upon a Time, Return of Dr. Mysterio, Husbands of River Song, Last Christmas, The Snowmen, The Runaway Bride, it ties with The End of Time Part 1, and A Christmas Carol, despite those stories getting substantially more in terms of actual viewership. I mentioned all of this last week. While the figure is disappointing, if you look at it all in context, holiday viewing figures have been down year on year on year on year. As long as Doctor Who can rank well in the actual day, I think we're going to be okay. But it's hard to tell if the episode's close proximity to the Series 11 finale might have hurt it or helped it. The second lowest ranked holiday special was The Husbands of River Song, and that had more or less the same gap between that special and its respective season. For Series 9, Hellbent was broadcast on December 5th, 2015, and then 20 days later we had The Husbands of River Song. And despite a year-long gap, The Return of Dr. Mysterio got slightly larger viewership than The Husbands of River Song. When compared side by side with the other holiday specials, the number is disappointing. But I don't think it's a coincidence that The Husbands of River Song and Resolution do share the bottom two spots. In terms of the viewership, maybe a story like Twice Upon a Time benefited from the 6-month gap between The Doctor Falls and that special. It meant the BBC could build up a marketing campaign that was much longer in the making. And maybe the advertising hindered it as well. There was basically zero presence for Resolution aside from a couple of magazine covers and the odd TV spot here and there, but the TV spots didn't really tease anything about the actual story, it didn't reveal the Dalek. There was that teaser which had the exterminator at the end of it, but I never saw that TV spot outside of Twitter. That was preaching to the choir. But that is pure conjecture on my part. Also, let's quickly take a look at the rankings for the Dalek stories now that we have the 7-day figures. With the overnight figures, it did rank quite low, but the 7-day boost actually helped its rankings in terms of Dalek stories. It performed better than Bad Wolf and The Parting of the Ways, Daleks in Manhattan, Evolution of the Daleks, though it does still lag behind Into the Dalek. Considering that the Dalek's presence was barely even confirmed to mainstream audiences, it's not a bad ranking, but I think there will be lengthy talks in the BBC press office come series 12. Will there be more trailers? Will the trailers show more? But once again, that is speculation and conjecture on my part. So, with all of that being said, let's talk about series 11 as a whole, and this series of videos doing these viewing figure breakdowns is some of the most controversial content that I have ever put out if you were to look at the comment section and look at the like and dislike bar. Which completely surprised me because all I'm really doing is just reporting the news and just reporting the facts. But it was most telling when the Saranga Conundrum got its 7-day figures and I was talking about Demons of the Punjab, and there were all of those headlines from tabloids and YouTubers and such, just flat out lying about the viewing figures and just saying how badly or how well Doctor Who was doing. Then I make a video calling out those people, and oddly enough, a large chunk of the comment section sided with the liars, which is completely antithetical to everything that I do. When it comes to why Series 11 got the viewing figures it did, why there was a drop-off, why there was a big spike, etc., etc., it's all conjecture. Nobody actually knows why it got the viewing figures that it has done. And when something is a theory, or is my opinion, or is conjecture, I will be completely upfront and say that it is. But in terms of just reporting the actual facts, people got really heated in the comment section. I think one of my favourite comments was when Rosa came out, and we had one commenter who was saying that Rosa was viewed by 3 million people and Thin Ice was viewed by 11 million. No, it wasn't. People saying I was just lying about the figures. I've never done that. And stuff like that is what has motivated me to do these viewing figure breakdowns. When I first started for The Woman Who Fell to Earth and the Ghost Monument, part of it, I've got to admit, was a little bit of spite. It was good seeing Doctor Who getting these great viewing figures when so many people were just adamant that it would immediately fail. And then by the time it got to Rosa and Arachnids in the UK, I just saw so much misinformation going around, I just felt like I just had to keep making these videos just to try and balance the scale somewhat. I just wanted to mention that before I talked about Series 11 as a whole. As soon as this video has been uploaded, I'm going to put it in a playlist. I'll put a link to that playlist in the description below so you can see me breaking down all of the viewing figures for all of the individual stories of Series 11. If you see a figure that you are confused about or you want a bit more context on, you'll be able to find that episode in the playlist. With that being said, before we talk about the 7-day figures, I'm going to talk about the BARB 28-day viewing figures. Now, I want to be clear, I am not going to compare these numbers to the 7-day figures. That is unfair. However, these numbers, they exist. They are tracked. They exist as bits of code on the internet and are now here for the world to see. As far as the world and facts are concerned, these are the definitive, final Doctor Who Series 11 viewership. So for The Woman Who Fell to Earth, we have 11.45 million. The Ghost Monument, 9.8 million. Rosa, 9 million. Arachnids in the UK, 8.7 million. The Saranga Conundrum, 8.32 million. Demons of the Punjab, 7.99 million. Kablam, 8.05 million. The Witchfinders, 7.64 million. It Takes You Away, 6.78 million. The Battle of Ranscourt Ave Colosse, 7.14 million. And the average is 8.48 million. So a couple of interesting things about these figures for the 10 episodes. There was a correct observation that between The Woman Who Fell to Earth and It Takes You Away, each episode was losing viewers. While there was an expected big dip between The Woman Who Fell to Earth and The Ghost Monument, although as pointed out last week, that's actually a much smaller dip than we have had for Series 1 and Series 5, where we had a new Doctor and a new showrunner, the actual dips themselves were pretty small. For example, we only lost 20,000 viewers between Demons of the Punjab and Kablam. But the 28-day figures do tell a slightly different story. From Demons of the Punjab, we actually got a slight increase up to Kablam. And just like the 7-day figures, the 28-day figures also had an increase from It Takes You Away to the Battle of Ranscourt Ave Colosse. And even though it won't be a big increase, we are going to see another increase with resolution for the 28-day figures, but I'm not going to count that here. But with the exception of It Takes You Away, no episode in Series 11 dipped under 7 million viewers, and that's pretty impressive. And even with just the 7-day figures, the only two episodes to dip under 7 million was It Takes You Away and the Battle of Ranscourt Ave Colosse. What really seems to have impacted Series 11 was that dip from The Witchfinders to It Takes You Away. That is the biggest dip that Series 11 had, with the exception of The Woman Who Fell to Earth to The Ghost Monument. And while I'm sure people are going to come into the comment section and say it's because the stories were terrible, firstly, that's just conjecture. There is no actual measurable way to discern that. The lowest audience appreciation index score for Series 11 was 79 for both the Saranga Conundrum and the Battle of Ranscourt of Kolos. The Witchfinders got 81. If there was going to be a big substantial dip, it would have happened after the Saranga Conundrum, if the AI score has anything to say about it. But I also don't think that it's a coincidence that the Witchfinders was the first story to be competing with I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here. And once that series found its viewership and started its momentum, then Series 11 did dip. But anyway, the 28-day viewing figures, the average of 8.48 million, that's a pretty successful series. When it comes to comparing other series with the 28-day viewing figures, we only have two others, Series 9 and Series 10. Series 9 had an average rating of 6.44, and Series 10 had average ratings of 5.88. But those are the only seasons that I can compare the 28-day viewing figures with, because for the rest of them we only have 7 days, so that's what I'm going to be doing from now on. So what I've done is that I've taken the 7-day figures of every episode of the revived series, with the exception of specials and one-offs, got the average figure for them, and have laid them out handily here for you. Series 10 stands at the lowest with 5.45, followed by Series 9 with 6.03. Ranking at the top is Series 4, no surprises there, with 8.04, and in second place we have Series 11 with 7.95, and in third place we have Series 1 just a smidge below it with 7.94. So if you just look at the averages, Doctor Who Series 11 is the second most successful series of Doctor Who since the show came back in 2005. I think it's quite fitting that Series 1 and Series 11 are so close to each other in terms of this number, because Series 1 and Series 11, they also lost around 4 million viewers over the course of their respective runs, except people weren't saying that Series 1 was an unmitigated failure when it lost 4 million viewers. But people with agendas have been for Series 11. I know some people might cry foul with just the averages, so I also did another ranking. What I did was that I took every single Doctor Who episode of the revived series, with the exception of specials and holiday specials and one-offs and such. I got the 7-day viewing figures for all 137 stories, and I have ranked them, from the most watched to the least watched, and each of them has a number. And then once that was all assembled, I took each of the season's individual rankings, and I found the averages of those. For example, Series 1 has the second most watched story, the 11th, 15th, 34th, 36th, 37th, 38th, 47th, 51st, 80th, 89th, 90th, and 92nd most viewed story of the revived series, and that averages out to 47.84. In first place, we have Series 4 with 46.38. A close second is Series 1 with 47.84. And then in third place, we have Series 1 with 52.3. So in terms of how Series 11 just ranks with all of the stories of the revived series, it ranks third. And when it comes to the average viewing figures, it ranks second. And considering that Series 10, just over a year ago, had the lowest viewing figures of the revived series, within 1 year, to see Series 11 just bounce immediately up the rankings, that's gotta be commended. And one more thing I think is worth pointing out is that Series 11 is the only series to be broadcast on a Sunday as opposed to a Saturday. Now, people have been saying incorrectly that nobody is watching TV on a Sunday. There's an argument going around that Doctor Who Series 11 only did as well as it did because it was broadcast on a Sunday and nobody was watching. We do actually have one more set of numbers that do kind of disprove that theory, and that is the audience share.
Pencils ready. Today we are going to learn about percentages.
Now let me explain. Let's say that 100 people were watching the Battle of Ranscourt of Kolos, but 1,000 people in total were just watching TV during that exact same time slot. That means the Battle of Ranscourt of Kolos would have a viewership of 10%. And here are the numbers. The Woman Who Fell to Earth got a viewership of 40.1%, the Ghost Monument 33.4%, Rosa 29.6%, so on and so on. The average audience share for Doctor Who Series 11 was 29.7%. So Series 11 was getting some of the highest viewing figures of the revived series so far, but was only averaging less than a third of the total audience viewership. Which is pretty impressive considering that nobody is watching TV on a Sunday, apparently. But here's where we hit a slight wrinkle. I can't find audience shares for previous seasons. I can find a couple of ones here and there, a couple of episodes here and there, but for the actual whole series, I can't find an average there. But just to give you some sort of a comparison, The Doctor's Wife, broadcast in 2011, had an audience share of 29.5%, with overnight figures of 6.09 million. In terms of overnight figures, the closest comparison is the Saranga Conundrum of 6.12 million, with an audience share of 29.5%. No, it's not a perfect comparison, but I think it works as a barometer. Either way, with an average viewership of 29.7% on a Sunday night, kind of shows to me that Series 11 was successful in that Sunday slot, not because or in spite of that change, but it just was. And people saying that the series would have been destroyed if it was on a Saturday night, there's honestly no way of knowing. It's pure conjecture, it's pure speculation. You are literally writing fan fiction viewing figures in your mind. Which is why I think this whole series of videos kind of became controversial, just for reporting the numbers and reporting the facts. Some people came into Series 11 with a deliberate axe to grind, but then when the viewing figures turned out so strong, they just lied about him, or tried to just dismiss the facts outright. And to quote the Fourth Doctor, these people don't alter their views to fit the facts, they alter the facts to fit their views. And that's why I have been so determined to keep up to date with the Series 11 viewership, just to let people know exactly what is happening. So what does this all mean? So basically, Series 11 did have one of the most successful runs since Doctor Who came back in 2005, but the fact that the 7-day viewership shows that there is a dip up until it takes you away, with a very slight increase for the Battle of Ranscarth Colossus, shows that hype for Series 11 was very front-loaded. Personally, I think it was because of all the great trailers and the promotional material that they had before the series came out, but by the time we got to the Saranga Conundrum and Demons of the Punjab, there was basically zero marketing. I think if they'd done something similar to Series 3 or Series 4 and put out a mid-series trailer, or had done something in the second half of the series to try and have a spike in viewership, like Dalek in Series 1 or Agatha Christie in Series 4, then that could have been avoided. Also, it would have been interesting to see what a two-parter did in Series 10 in terms of the viewership, and what would have happened to It Takes You Away in the Battle of Ranscarth Colossus if I'm a Celebrity Get Me Out of Here wasn't broadcasting in those weeks. But when you look at the series averages between Series 1 and Series 11, if you take away Series 4, the best performing series are Series 11, Series 1, and Series 5. Those are seasons with a brand new Doctor and a brand new showrunner, and as I pointed out last week, they're also the seasons with the biggest dip in terms of a percentage. I don't think that's a coincidence. With Series 12, I don't think we're going to have viewership as high as Series 11, but we may have something akin to Series 2 or Series 6. Where the figures aren't quite as strong, but they are a bit more consistent, they don't fluctuate as much. But in my opinion, one reason Season 4 did as good as it did was because it was preceded by Voyage of the Damned, which was the most watched Doctor Who revived series episode ever. And a trailer for Series 4 followed that special. It worked really well as Season 4's hype man. And with Season 12 rumoured to broadcast in very early 2020, if we are going to get a Christmas or a New Year special in the end of 2019 or the beginning of 2020, it will be interesting to know if that special is able to serve as Series 12's hype man. And let's see for Season 12 if the BBC can market it throughout the entire duration, as opposed to marketing just the first 5 weeks of the show. My name is Mr. TARDIS, thank you so much for watching these videos, playlist in the description below. Be sure to hit that like button because it really, really helps me out, and also subscribe for more Doctor Who related content. I've not got any new Doctor Who to talk about in 2019, so in terms of other reaction videos or other things to talk about, I'm really looking forward to that War of the Worlds series. I might do something on that, but anyway, let's see what 2019 holds. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you folks next time.